Oh, hey, sup, it's Ralph Bob.
Oh, hey, sup, guys. I hope you're doing well. I wanted to make a video on how to increase the rank of your legendary cloak and get it to max rank quickly so you can start getting more corruption resistance. There are quite a few players that are putting this off, and I can't stress the importance of getting these ranks, especially now since Blizzard has lowered the cost of upgrading your cloak, so you don't have to do as many horrific visions. Getting this cloak leveled as soon as possible means you'll be able to equip more corruptions, which will drastically improve your character's performance. Make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel for more WoW content and news as we move into Shadowlands. I'm only one man and doing my best to try to put one video together a week, so be sure to ring the bell to make sure when those videos go out. Now, let's get into what you need to start ranking up your cloak. First off, I'm gonna assume that you've done the quest line already. You get your cloak. Doing the quest line will unlock your assaults, which for this to work quickly, you need to be doing these dailies and assaults every time they are up, because they give you the currency coalescing visions, which are needed to get into the horrific vision. Blizzard did a pretty bad job of naming these things, so this is going to get a little confusing, so bear with me with all of these. So doing an Azoth assault will give you 12,500 coalescing visions. Doing any other assault will give you 6,500. These assaults change twice a week, so make sure to check back often and do them every time they're up. Make sure to do the mini vision too, which could either be an Uldum or Veil of Eternal Blossoms. It's one or the other. It's not in both every time, so make sure to check that. And doing the daily, the first daily in the week will give you 3,000, and then the rest of them throughout the week will give you 1,500. So make sure to just do those. And also, I recommend when you're first starting to stay in these mini visions for as long as possible and kill as many bad guys in there, because they drop coalescing visions, but also more importantly, they have a chance to drop corrupted mementos, which early, starting out early, you need as many of these as possible to purchase the upgrades, which will help boost your effectiveness inside the visions. And these upgrades are hugely important. After the daily stuff, you can finally step into the horrific visions after buying a vessel for 10,000 coalescing visions. Told you it's a little bit confusing. They named everything visions, and it makes it pretty much impossible to explain this stuff properly. The game gives you a few vessels for free and also gives you enough coalescing visions to purchase more of these vessels before you even finish the cloak quest line. So your cloak starts at rank 1, and to upgrade it, Rathion requires an item that you get from defeating the main boss of a horrific vision, and that's it. That's all you need to do for the first couple ranks. So you most likely will die on your first trip into a vision, but don't be upset by that. After you get your first upgrade in the Titanic Research Archive, it'll let you put down 3 orbs that restore your sanity. Use these and make sure to clear out the first entire zone of the horrific vision, because everything you kill in the vision gives you mementos, which is important. Kill the last boss and you get the item in the chest at the end of the vision, and you can repeat this 4 times and you get your cloak up to rank 5 really quick. Should be rank 5 in the first day. The next 2 ranks, you need to push a bit further into the vision. You need to go into and kill the boss in one of the more difficult zones, the preceding zones. That is not part of the main section. I'll show the map in a second. You don't need to kill the main boss to get the quest item. Remember this. A lot of people think they need to actually finish the vision to get the quest item to rank up their cloak, which isn't true. So you get rank 6 and 7 with just killing the first boss, or one of the bosses that isn't the main boss out in the first zone. To get rank 8, you need 2 of these pages. So I recommend doing both of the sections, and don't worry about killing the main boss. I've gone in on my tank, my warrior tank, killed both of the optional bosses, which are the ones you need for the pages. And I didn't get to kill the main boss of Stormwind, but I still got the two pages and I still ranked up my cloak, which is the most important part. We're trying to do this quickly and we're trying to optimize your horrific vision so you're not wasting vessels and you can get to rank 15 within a week or two. Eventually, you'll need to get four pages, which means you need to do two horrific visions just to rank up one time. And then once you hit rank 10, you'll need to finally go into the more difficult zones and you'll need to repeat this process the same you did with the last one. You finish off one of the zones, you get your quest item, and then you have to do both of those end zones. You can skip the other ones. As long as you get those main, the ones you need for the quest done, you'll get the item. At this point, you should have enough upgrades to get you through these zones fairly swiftly to get the items you need to hit rank 15 on your cloak. The key is to not skip out on your dailies and weeklies to feel your horrific visions. Once you hit max rank, if you complete a full 5 boss vision, you will receive a Malefic Core, which will increase your cloak's corruption resistance by 3. And after all the visions you've done, you can also buy these Malefic Cores from Mother and get your resistance really high to enable you to wear that delicious corrupted gear. I hope this helped. If there's any questions, leave a comment. If this helped, leave a like. Make sure to subscribe, ring the bell, and follow us over at twitch.tv/RalphBob, where I stream 5 nights a week on the East Coast. So 8 p.m. on the East Coast, 5 p.m. Pacific. And I hope you guys keep it rock solid. Have a good one. Peace.